r/AskReddit. What is the creepiest thing that society accepts as a cultural norm? People knowing every detail about celebrities' lives. Not even their lives though. Just being invested in celebrities in general. I know someone who literally cried when Kylie Jenner and Travis Scott broke up. Talking completely seriously about how they don't believe in love anymore even though their parents have been happily married for over 25 years. Child beauty pageants are for who? Exactly? Who enjoys them? And why? The more you really think about it, the less happy you should be. Seriously, I just rewatched Little Miss Sunshine a few hours ago and seeing all those little girls caked in makeup made me feel super uncomfortable. Snap map on Snapchat. Most people don't turn it off and you can just see where a person is and where they live and the last they were on Snapchat. I read Snapman and then read the rest of your post with fear that a Snapman is some creature that knows where you are and is stalking. He she is bullying you because he she likes you. I had a girl throw a glass bottle at me in middle school and it gave me a hell of a black eye. I told an adult this story and she was like, "Oh, she must really like you." Was like, "What? I hope not, cause I called the cops on her." Feeding children disgusting amounts of sugar and then blaming them for being fat. On that note, not allowing kids to run around outside, but then complaining about their lack of fitness. Televangelists. These people should not be out in the wild, controlling, manipulating, molding their audience to give as much as they can as the Lord has spoken to them and they require a nuclear jet. All psychological showmen and their target audience laps it all up and defends their every action with gusto. Being charged with being a beast, they were doing God's work but they also needed that new mansion to stop the flood. Give now so you can get in the pearly gates with Q-Jumper, TM. How they are allowed to peddle their biblical fanfiction nonsense to the impressionable actually makes them beyond creepy. It's normal to give up your personal data for no good reason. If you refuse or voice your concern, people look at you weird because why do you care if you have nothing to hide? Recording literally everything about their lives for clout. No pics. It didn't happen. The race to losing your virginity. It seriously messes with some people's minds. I think being exposed to porn at a young age gives you inaccurate ideas about sex, and makes what you're talking about more messed up. Rich famous people being pedophiles. Separation of church and state not actually being separated. Parents essentially recording a child's entire life from baby to adult on social media. It's disturbing to me how many parents will do this with zero regard for how their child will feel about it later in life. I'm actually so glad I was born a decade before Facebook even existed. I imagine this is going to become more of a mainstream political issue in the next couple of decades. In the form of Gen Z Greek letter alpha people demanding stronger child privacy rights as they realize their entire lives have been laid bare for all to see. I completely agree. YouTubers using their kids for views clout being the most vile offenders imo. Brush off the idea that men can't get sexually assaulted or abused. I'm European and I think it might make people uncomfortable how okay I am with nudity. I think the world would be a better place if nudity stopped being so vilified. Like, we're born naked. Simply being naked doesn't have to be sexual. Not allowing elderly people to decide when they want to die. Who the hell wants to live with dementia? Obviously the retirement home's healthcare industry makes trillions off this. Which is who shaped our beliefs on the subject in the first place without even realizing it. I agree with this. We are more humane to our animals' suffering than people. There has to be a way to provide someone with that choice. Advanced directive like. Shaming people, particularly children, for having certain diseases or needing medical care. Mental health, for example, depression, springs to mind. But complex disorders like epilepsy, cystic fibrosis, or even endometriosis invite inappropriate public comment. Patients are told they are lazy, liars, or should just die for being disabled. I worked at a health science hospital center where we had public protesters every time a healthcare issue made the news. It was creepy and felt dangerous, volatile. Making kids be affectionate when they don't want it. The whole idea of give them a hug goodbye, or give grandma a kiss. Screw that. I never made my kid do anything like that. I don't care whose feelings got hurt. My cousin-in-law is fond of trying to get her kids to give us hugs and kisses. When we only see them at Christmas, I always go for the high five or fist bump instead, and you can see the look of relief on their faces that they don't have to hug yet another semi-stranger. Pretty much any TV show that has secret footage, I saw in Rearing of What Not to Wear recently where someone was thinking of not doing it and one of the response was, well, we only stalked you a little. IDK if it's just that I'm older now, but most reality TV really freaks me out. It's all scripted, so it's not really secret footage. Grown men making comments on young girls' bodies. This is super common where I'm from, and TBH I think men who do this should be shot or put in the ground. Or those creepy countdown calendars till a child celebrity turns 18. Paparazzis. They have killed many celebrities and done nothing but snap pictures while they were dying. There is no freedom for these poor people that wanted nothing but to pursue their dream. Former secretary here. The worst person I ever had to speak to on the phone was a paparazzi guy who would not stop calling us. He was kicked out of our property in NYC because a production had a permit for the normally public space, and he was kicked out. He was so demeaning to me and overall the biggest ass I've ever had to talk to. Worst part was he kept calling but wouldn't take. They have a permit, so the space is closed to the public for an answer. My co-worker and I hung up on him a few times when the swearing wouldn't stop. That in America, if you go to jail or prison for any reason, you are allowed to be brutalized, raped and treated as subhuman with zero rights. Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Those things are always listening and hear everything you say and do. Yet everyone has them and Spotify was handing them out for free. Each day we get closer to a 1984 situation. It's weird how, when you go to a men's tailor, they go up one side, move it over, they go up the other, move it back, and then they do the back. Those fake, real looking baby dolls. Countdowns to when a famous woman turns 18. Like being able to say that she's legal now doesn't lower the creep factor. Billie Eilish IDK how to spell her last name, for example. I can't imagine how uncomfortable she was when everyone was literally counting down the days until she turned 18. How bothered people are about what sexuality a celebrity is. Spouses cheating on each other. It's a horrible thing to do to someone, but people treat it like it's juicy gossip. My friends in sororities talking about how they only socialize with frats within their tier, aka the top 3 hottest frats only have parties with the top 3 hottest sororities, or how during rush week they eliminate people purely based on looks. Made me uncomfortable how they acknowledged they know it's wrong but it's just the way it is. Pretending that terrible things are happening in their community every night. I don't understand why so many people will let others suffer and die to maintain the illusion that they live in a good neighborhood or stuff like that doesn't happen here, instead of taking action to actually have a good community. The notion that you can't have a sense of morality without religion. Taking photos, videos of strangers, public proposals, someone dressed in a funny outfit, seeing people get wedding photos taken in a public place and deciding to photograph the bride, etc. I always get really frustrated when I see something like a proposal go down and they're suddenly encased in a circle of people with their phones out. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.